Okay, so Lucinda was dealing with a toothache last week, and this week she's having that tooth yanked out. Ugh. So she can't be here. But seeing as this has been pretty much the most misogynistic couple of weeks in her lifetime, she asked me if I could step in and make sure that we got a This Week in Misogyny into this episode. So yeah, I'm sure that you don't need me to tell you that the legally protected right to an abortion is pretty much already dead. It'll take a while for the Supreme Court to give us a time of death, and we still don't know if they're gonna slit her throat or beat her comatose and keep her on life support. But one way or another, the Grim Reaper is hovering. The nation's top legal minds got together with Alito, Thomas, Gorsuch, Kavanaugh, and Barrett to hear arguments about the constitutionality of Mississippi's 15-week abortion ban. And to be clear, either the law is unconstitutional or every previous iteration of the court since 1970-fucking-3 was wrong. And it took the brilliant legal scholars that Donald fucking Trump appointed to finally notice. It's one of those two options. Yeah. So, yeah. That's bad. We'll find out just how bad in the coming months and years. But the only people who are even pretending it won't be bad are people who are lying about what bad means. And just to add insult to injury, it's all happening because this country is too sexist to elect a woman as president. Of course, as dominant as this news story is, it's hardly the only sexism in the news. So let me knock out a few more stories here. We've got the story of Dr. Burnett L. Robinson. And by doctor, I mean doctorate in divinity. So doesn't know anything, but doesn't know it really hard. Not sure. Anyway, Robinson was the senior pastor at Grand Concourse Seventh-day Adventist Church in the Bronx until a clip of one of his sermons went viral in which he, as Eli and Heath would phrase it, ranked the rapes. In a tirade about how submissive Christian women are supposed to be, he said, and I quote,
I saw in court the other day on TV where a lady sued her husband for rape. And I would say to you, gentlemen, the best person to rape is your wife. End quote.
So yeah, a list of who would be best to rape is a thing Burnett L. Robinson has. But you want to know a thing he doesn't have? A fucking job, because after the video hit YouTube, he was forced to resign. So I guess your own career is also on the acceptable end of his things to rape list. I also need to give a shout out to the very awesome group of ladies that put together a fundraiser for Planned Parenthood on the campus of the very Christian Loyola Marymount University in LA. They're the LMU Women in Politics group, and I don't know how well their fundraiser did in terms of dollars, but it pissed the administrators and alumni off bad enough that they're looking into changing rules and policies and shit in response. And to me, that makes it a success, even if you didn't raise a dollar. And with that, I'm gonna wrap things up. Lucinda should be back next week, but until then, I'll be crying in the shower, and I'll go ahead and hand you back to Noah, Heath, and Eli.